Kroger Tender Ray Beef, no other beef so fresh can be so tender, presents Hearts in Harmony, transcribed. K is for Kroger, C is for cut, B is for beef. KCB means Kroger cut beef, and Kroger cut beef means more meat for your money. Remember that fact, ladies. Remember that Kroger cut beef gives you more meat, less waste, and for this reason. Before the meat is weighed and priced, the Kroger method of cutting beef removes excess bone, excess waste, and stringy ends. Yes, that's before the meat is weighed and priced. And listen, you get the top U.S. government grades of beef. Yes, sirree. It's tender, juicy, rich red, and marbled with just the right amount of flavory fat. So you get better value in top-grade beef. Let's take a Kroger cut chuck roast as an example. Before the roast is weighed and priced, the Kroger method of cutting beef removes excess waste and stringy meat. You're bound to get a better value because you get more solid meat, only a minimum of bone. No matter which you prefer, steak or roast, you receive more meat, less waste in Kroger cut beef. But make that discovery for yourself. Visit your neighborhood Kroger store and get Kroger cut beef. It gives you more meat for your money. And now, Hearts in Harmony. Peg Martin has convinced Penny Gibbs that it's wise if she doesn't set an early wedding date with Barry Carlton. Penny accepts this as friendly advice, not at all suspecting that Peg herself has intentions of marrying the young millionaire. It's an hour after dinner in the Gibbs home, and the phone rings.
Hello?
Hello, Nora.
Oh, yes, Miss Gibbs.
Nora, look, I'll be downtown longer than I planned, so I thought I'd better phone you.
Well, there's nothing wrong, is there?
No, there isn't. Johnny didn't have those sketches ready for Jed, so I'll wait here until he finishes them.
Where's here, Miss Gibbs?
I'm in Johnny's office.
Oh, all right.
Oh, Nora, has Barry Carlton called?
Oh, no, he hasn't.
Oh, well, I expect him to. If he does, tell him where I am and tell him I'll phone him when I get home.
All right, Miss Gibbs, I'll tell him.
Thanks, Nora. Bye.
Bye.
What's the matter, Nora? Gibbsy stuck downtown?
Yes, Freddy. She has to wait for Mr. Keith to finish some drawings for Mr. Billings.
Oh, well, I guess you won't be home for a long time then.
Mm-mm.
Guess we're stuck here, huh?
Well, we can go to the movies if you want to, Freddy. Mrs. Billings will watch after the children.
Well, we don't want to ask her to do that, do we? After all, she had a tough day with Mr. Billings and the doctors.
Oh, yes, she has, hasn't she?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I don't mind staying home.
I don't either.
Either?
I'm sorry, I don't either.
That's better. Do the doctors have anything good to say about Mr. Billings?
Well, no, it was just a routine checkup today. Mm-hmm. But I hear that they're going to give him one every month. Mm-hmm. And there's no hope that he'll ever walk again. Guess everybody's given up on that.
Everybody but Mr. Billings.
Yeah. And that's what gets you, too. You know, the guy it's toughest on, he's taking it the easiest. Mm-hmm. Some guy, that Mr. Billings. Mm-hmm. Only hope I'm like him when I'm his age.
Wonder what you and I'll be like, Freddy, when we're 60 years old.
Well, I got a rough idea that we'll be just like 60 years old.
A wonderful description, Freddy.
Well, let's not talk about what it'll be like when we're 60. It's tough enough to figure the ways and the wife wars and everything else just the way it is right now.
I thought you were happy, Freddy.
Well, Nora, I'm not happy seeing people get kicked around. And the kicker's getting away with it.
What do you mean?
I mean you got to close your eyes and put cotton in your ears not to see and hear what Peg Martin's doing to Gibbsy. And I told Gibbsy about it just the other day, and what did she do? She just patted me on the head and said, thanks, but I know all about that, and it's okay.
What did she know about?
What I heard Peg Martin saying to Julie about marrying Barry Carlton.
Mrs. Martin said she was going to marry Mr. Carlton?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, crickets, Freddy, I don't...
You don't believe it either, do you?
No.
I guess nobody will believe it. But I heard Peg giving Julie the 1, 2, 3 on how to win friends and influence Barry Carlton.
Oh, you must have misunderstood, Freddy. I heard Mrs. Martin telling Miss Gibbs how thrilled she was because Miss Gibbs was going to marry Mr. Carlton.
Look, Nora, Peg Martin is one of those dames who can say one thing and think three other things all at the same time. I tell you, she's going to try to get her hooks into Barry Carlton if she has to step all over Gibbsy's dead body to do it.
Freddy, I suspected Mrs. Martin of being sort of bad once, too. But I realize now it's just because I didn't understand her. Well, she's awfully nice, and she wouldn't do anything to hurt Miss Gibbs.
No, she doesn't want to hurt her. She just wants to practically kill her and make it as painless as possible.
You're wrong, Freddy. I'm sure you are.
No, sir.
No. Oh, now look how nice Miss Gibbs has been to Mrs. Martin. She's let her live here and brought her daughter to live here, too. And Mrs. Martin is happy now, where before she was awfully unhappy.
Yes, and I remember when she came here sobbing about a no-good husband and a kid that she didn't have enough money to support.
Her husband was an awfully bad person, Freddy.
Yeah, sure he was. But I'm beginning to wonder what made him that way, Crickets. You know, maybe it was his wife that drove him nuts.
Freddy, she loved him very much.
Peg Martin's the kind of a dame that can't love anybody but herself. And if I were her, I couldn't love myself either. I tell you, she's trying to put the skids under Penny and grab Barry Carlton and his dough for herself.
Freddy, I won't let you talk about her that way. You have no way of proving anything you're saying.
Well, I know what I heard her say to her daughter.
You told Miss Gibbs what she said, didn't you?
Yeah.
And did Miss Gibbs get upset about it?
Well, no, but she
doesn't
understand.
Well, then that ought to prove that you don't know what you're talking about. You just didn't understand what Mrs. Martin was saying, that's all.
Well, maybe I didn't. But I'm still going to keep an eye on that Martin dame just the same.
Freddy, let's not talk about it.
Okay. Only makes me mad when I do. Say, where is Peg anyway?
Oh, out on the porch with Julie.
Oh.
Freddy, isn't it exciting about Miss Gibbs and Mr. Carlton?
Yeah, if it works out all right.
Oh, you know it will.
Well, I promised I'd keep my yap closed about the Martin dame, so I will.
Oh, Freddy, it's going to be wonderful for Miss Gibbs. Just think how rich she'll be.
I can't think of numbers that high.
I heard once that he has $10 or $15 million all his own.
Crickets, when it gets past $1 million, I stop getting excited. I just get numb.
Well, maybe you'll have $1 million someday.
Who, me?
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm not cut out for cash like that. I'm the kind of guy who's someday going to have just a little fold of money in his pocket and something in maybe four figures in the bank for old age or that rainy day. And maybe if I'm lucky, I can run the bank account up into five figures. But the first one won't be big.
Oh, it must be wonderful to be rich. I wonder if you feel different inside than when you're poor.
Well, I don't know, Crickets. I only know what it's like to feel poor. That isn't too bad, really. So, what if you are gold-plated inside? I don't think you'd feel any better. Maybe worse.
You know, I wonder if Miss Gibbs thinks about how rich she'll be.
No, I don't think so, Crickets. Not Gibbsy.
Well, I would. I'd think about clothes and cars and going to beautiful parties.
Hey, now, wait a minute.
Hmm?
You aren't turning money happy on me, are you?
Oh, no, Freddy. I was dreaming for Miss Gibbs.
Yeah, but you sounded just like it was something you'd like to have yourself.
Well, I would. Everybody'd like to have lots of money. Oh, but it's not important if you don't.
Well, if you want it and you don't have it, it's plenty important. And I warn you, Crickets.
Yeah?
I'm never going to be any Barry Carlton in the pocketbook. Look, when you marry me, you're going to be lucky if you know whose picture is on the back of a $10 bill. That is, of course, in case I start making my own.
Oh, Crickets, Freddy, when we're married, it won't matter if we aren't rich. Well, we aren't rich now, and it doesn't matter.
No, it doesn't matter now, but what happens in a few years? And maybe you can land somebody with a big bankroll. Will I still look good to you then, Nora?
Oh, Freddy, how did we get into this mess?
Well, you went gaga for Gibbsy because she's marrying a pile of dough.
Well, that was for her, Freddy, not for me. I don't care if we never have any money, as long as we have enough to get along on. Oh, believe me, Freddy, I mean it. Please believe me.
Sure, Crickets. Sure, I believe you.
Honestly?
Sure, you bet I do. I'll believe anything you say, providing it's what I want you to say.
Oh, you.
Hey, what's that?
It's Julie out on the front porch. Something's happened to her.
Her mother probably slugged her one for...
Freddy, you promised.
I'm sorry, Nora. Come on, let's go out and see what the trouble is.
Maybe we shouldn't interfere.
Well, the kid's still crying.
Yeah.
Maybe Peg needs help. What is it?
Oh, Julie, what's the matter, honey?
I fell.
Oh.
My dog fell off the porch and I fell after her.
Oh, you're going to be all right, kid. Come here, let's have a look at you.
Where does it hurt, Julie?
Nowhere, I guess. Just everywhere.
Oh, come on now, Julie. Big girls don't cry.
But I'm a little girl.
There, that's better. Oh, your dress is torn.
Torn?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Mommy will be mad at me. Well, she'll scold and scold.
Oh,
hey,
no.
Julie, where is your mother?
She went away.
Huh?
She went away? Where?
Big car came by and went slow. Mommy left and went down the street,
The big car stopped, and Mommy got in, and the big car went away.
A big car, Julie?
Real big, Uncle Freddy.
Barry Carlton. Nora, he's the only guy in Rossville who drives a car that big.
No, Freddy, it couldn't be.
Well, it could be, and it was.
Oh, Aunt Nora. Mommy will be so mad because I tore my dress. Will it fit?
Of course it will, Julie. Now, you go upstairs and change into another dress, and I'll fix it for you so your mother will never know it.
You won't tell I tore it, Uncle Freddy?
I'll say I won't, Julie.
Oh, thank you, Uncle Freddy. I'll go change my dress right away, Aunt Nora.
Okay.
Come on, Henrietta Josephine. Everything's going to be all right now. Mommy won't know
it.
We won't get into any trouble.
Gee, it's awful for Julie to be afraid because she tore her dress. When I was little, I was always tearing mine.
So, she's out with Barry Carlton, huh? Out with Barry Carlton.
Freddy, you don't know for sure.
Well, Gibbsy's been expecting him to call, hasn't she?
Well, yes, but that doesn't
mean... Well, that's the answer to why he hasn't called. He sneaked out with Peg Martin. I'm going to do something about this, I tell you, Nora. I'm going to fix that dame if it's the last thing I do.
You're not going to tell her, Freddy Lang. I won't let you do it.
Well, somebody ought to tell her something about
it. Somebody ought to tell who something.
Oh, hello, Miss Gibbs.
Hello, Nora.
Hi, Gypsy.
Hello, Freddy.
Hey, you really had quite a wait for those drawings, didn't you?
Yeah, I sure did. But it was fascinating to watch Johnny make them.
Yeah?
Yeah. I've never seen anything like it before. Oh, I'm tired.
Oh, well, you were up early this morning, Miss Gibbs.
I guess that's it, Nora. Mm-hmm. Did Barry Carlton phone?
Oh, well, No, Miss Gibbs, he hasn't. Not yet.
Well, that's funny. It's kind of late. I wonder if something's the matter. Maybe I should call him.
Well, no, Gibbsy, I wouldn't do that.
Why not, Freddy?
Well, because if... Well, if you want a little advice to the lovelorn, Gibbsy, it's... Oh, well, a guy doesn't like the dame he loves to call him up.
He doesn't? Well,
nope.
Why not?
Well, it's just because
what
he's
what Freddy
like...
means is he's probably busy and has work to do, and if you called him, he wouldn't want to do his work.
Yeah, sure, that's all right. That's right. Well, maybe he's out with another girl.
Another girl?
Oh, Freddy. Freddy's only joking, Miss Gibbs.
Yeah, that's right, Gibbsy. You know, me and my sense of humor.
Well, I really can't imagine why he didn't call. He promised me he would, and he's always kept a promise.
Is Peg Martin out with Barry Carlton? Why didn't Barry phone Penny as he promised? Has Peg Martin already begun to turn Barry away from Penny Gibbs? Be sure to listen to the next dramatic episode of Hearts in Harmony. KCB. KCB. KCB means Kroger cut beef, and Kroger cut beef means more meat for your money. Right. Kroger cut beef gives you more meat, less waste, because before the meat is weighed and priced, the Kroger method of cutting beef removes excess bone, excess waste, and stringy ends. Take a Kroger cut round steak or roast, for example. The Kroger method of cutting beef removes excess waste and stringy meat before the steak or roast is weighed and priced. You get a minimum of bone, and you get top U.S. government grades of beef. Beef that's tender, juicy, rich red, and marbled with just the right amount of flavory fat. But visit your neighborhood Kroger store and see for yourself. Remember, whether you buy a steak or a roast, Kroger cut beef gives you more meat for your money. Ladies, make plans right this instant to visit your neighborhood Kroger store, the only place you can buy Kroger cut beef. Surprise and delight your family with a delicious and juicy steak or roast. And remember, in Kroger cut beef, you get more meat for your money, because the Kroger method of cutting beef gives you more meat, less waste. Get Kroger cut beef right away at your neighborhood Kroger store. Be sure to join us again tomorrow, same time, same station, for another thrilling transcribed chapter of Hearts in Harmony.